Hello guys, welcome to our challenge Learn with Rahul. So today we are going to talk about the study upon translation in India. The word that is about translation studies, and we are going to give you a review upon the translation study. The main theme is practice of translation in India. Here, as you can see here. Now first, the word translate comes from the Latin word translatio, translatio, where transmit across and latus means carrying. Translation in India, brief overview today. So guys, आज हम आप लोगों को translation के बारे में overview देने वाले हैं. So let's see, this could be a helpful information for every one of you. There are actually two distinct language families in India, the Indo-Aryan and Dravidian, Dravidian. The most ancient of the Dravidian languages is Tamil, and the others are Kannada, Telugu and Malayalam. Sanskrit was the dominant language in the northern part of India in the ancient time, but other languages like Sanskrit was the dominant language in the northern part of India, but in the ancient times. But other languages like Prakrit, Pali, Apabhramsa were used as languages of communication by the common muses. Sanskrit was the language of literature and religious rites. As India passed into medieval period, the influence of Sanskrit declined. Persian became the dominant language because it was the language of the court. It was also considered to be a light language of scholarship and Mughal rulers. Babarnama, the autobiography of Babur, was originally written in the language called Chagatai, but was translated into Persian by Humayun's minister Birnam, as you all know, Birnam Khan. The Mahabharata and the Bhagavad Gita were also translated into Persian during Akbar's time. Next page, we are going to have some more knowledge overview about translation. So guys, with you. Translation in this period had many important results. Number one, it helps to make people bilingual. It means most of them knew the languages, or even most of them knew two languages or even more. Number two, it gave rise to new language like Urdu, which was the result of the interaction of Persian with local language. Number three, translations from the works had the effect of introducing the Persian with local language. After all, we can say without hesitation that translations helped to make Indian culture what it is today, a happy bleeding of multiple cultural influences. Bilingualism is a common Indian trait even today. That's all guys. So aaj humne de diya humko translation study ki review. Hope you guys like it. So give a thumbs up, subscribe to my challenge, need your support, love you all, take care, over and out.